r/cheating stories. Update. I don't know if I have a cheating story. I tried to update earlier but it would not post. I contacted the mods but have no response yet. So I will give another go. First, I want to thank everyone for their responses. We are going to take this weekend and talk it out. First, a little background, as I am going to describe this from my wife's thinking. You should know about us. We both come from a small suburban town. We both grew up in fairly conservative families. Our families have known each other for years. We both went to a Christian school, then on to Christian college. We were HS sweethearts and each other's firsts. We did have sex in college, only with each other, if that means anything. We both have admitted to kissing someone else, but no more than that. We talked on the phone after her goodnight to our son. I said I would call back at 9 p.m., that is if you are not busy. I know it was a smart aleck move. She did not answer, so I repeated I would call her at 9. 9 o'clock comes around, I call and she is crying and blubbering. I wait. Then as she calms down, I told her we needed to talk this out. For now, I need to know her thinking. What have I done to make you want to cheat? How long have you been cheating? Who is it with? So this is some of what she told me. I listened and did not interrupt unless she went silent. The wife was promoted to a position that would require her to travel occasionally, essentially for training. The company always put their people up in a nice hotel near the training. We have been to hotels ourselves, but always the more economy class. The hotels she has stayed in had restaurants and a bar. In 2019, she went to her first training requiring 2 overnights. She was with a couple others attending the training. She had the names of the people attending and they all agreed to meet up for dinner the first night. They ate, then went to the bar. I imagine she was overwhelmed because we are not bars or club people. She says she was half listening to the conversation and watching everything. A woman walks into the bar dressed in a business suit. She has a lanyard around her neck. She could see it was an it of sorts, as she had one also, but they were different companies. The woman sat at the bar chatting with the bartender. He got busy, so she was by herself. About 5 minutes later, a man walked over to get a drink and started a conversation. He got his drink and offered to buy her another. They talked about 15 minutes, got another drink and moved to a table. Another drink comes and they take the drinks and walk out of the bar together. My wife thought I just saw a pickup that will be aeons. The next night after training and dinner, the group headed to the bar. In walks the woman, dressed businesslike. This time she catches the it from a large well-known company. The woman gets a drink and heads to a table as the bartender is too busy to talk. In a little while, a different man than from the night before leaves his table and approaches her. She invites him to sit down. They have a couple drinks and the same as the night before, they head out together. My wife mentions it to the group. One of the more veteran employees told her that while it's not common for pickups, it's not uncommon either. There is the anonymity of aeons between two adults that are lonely and little chance of being caught. This caught her interest, which then turned into fantasy. She had 3 or 4 more trainings that year. On some nights she saw hookups, on others she did not. 2020 came and travel was stopped. But her fantasies did not. When we had sex, she admitted thinking she was having aeons. To be honest, we are not good at expressing what we want sexually, so she kept this just in her head. However, she had convinced herself she could have sex with someone else and would be able to separate the emotional from the physical. In April of this year, they started travel again. She traveled 2 nights. This time there were 2 others with her. Same thing, dinner then to the bar. They had drinks but she saw no action. She had brought the lingerie. It's actually a one-piece that covers her breasts and torso. It's black and lacy. Now that I'm writing this, I forget what she called it. Well, as I wrote yesterday, you are onto something, and onto something you are, holy moly. Well, talk it out. Talk it out deep and lengthy with every detail. You both need to re-establish a good communication. Apparently your wife seems to have fantasies, which might have been triggered by the feeling, well, I never had my wild year in college experience, so I've got to taste that. But I think you caught it early enough and she's coming clean. You have to come up with boundaries and express your expectation as detailed as it gets. I've traveled in my days extensively, so extensively, that today I despise ANY airport and prefer a road trip regardless of the length. I've seen it all, the pickup, male co-workers removing their wedding rings upon entering the bar, the works. Hell, I even lost a job, because my boss, female, wanted to pick me up and I told her flat out nope, not gonna happen, as I'm happily married to my wife, I'm 55 today. So fantasies is one thing, acting them out another. Tell her, that the thought initiate an affair. Not the act, the fantasy, the thinking about it, prepares for the reality to come. It is on her to choose. And no, that's not a mistake. A mistake is putting salt in a cup of coffee, thinking it's sugar. Straying from a marriage is a willful decision. I think if you make that all clear to her, she will get the gist, that she was playing with fire, and about to burn her fingers. Lastly, yes, I'd tell her, that in ways your trust has been at least dinged if not dented, and it is on to you to determine the size of the dent top. All the best, you did the right thing and talk with her. Now for the next story. My fiancé cheated on me with his best friend and I don't think I'll ever get over this. I've posted a few times now on different threads but I just feel the need to talk to someone who isn't involved in the situation, so this is my only place to come. My fiancé and I were together for 6 years. He was my everything. I gave up so much to make our relationship work, including job opportunities in other states, because he had a great job here in California and I didn't want to ruin that for him. He was a great guy. He always stood up for me even when I acted psycho. He went with me to BLM protests, he helped pay off my student loans. He was never someone you'd ever think would cheat. His best friend and him were extremely close, and during quarantine somehow got closer instead of suffer from the distance. He always chose her over me, but I always saw it as him having friends outside our circle which I was happy about. He has lots of female friends so why should she bother me but the rest don't? Then he started having sex dreams about her and claiming he wasn't. And then he started getting possessive about who she hung out with, and worrying about every little thing she did. Yet I'd tell him I twisted my ankle at work and he'd just hum and turn back to the TV. I never had a problem with her. She was always nice to me. She would even try and encourage him to spend more time helping me plan our wedding. She always seemed like this insecure shy girl who didn't have much confidence. But she played me. They slept together, at some point about a month ago, and nobody felt the need to tell me including numerous of our friends who all knew apparently. I come home last week and find them in bed. He claims they were going to tell me when I got home that night but I know that's not true, because why else would they have waited a month since the first time it happened? He claims that even if we were married he still would have picked her over me because it was always her. He always was going to pick her if she gave him a chance. She wasn't this naive sweet girl, in fact I think she's a fucking slut. Now that I'm paying more attention I'm realizing she plays all these boys she hangs out with to get attention and get what she wants but then goes back to my now ex-fiancé every time. I'm hurt and I can't get over it. I try to cut them out but I can't. I can't stop myself from wanting to watch them in hopes she breaks his heart, but she won't because life doesn't work like that. It's his birthday today which is why I think I'm having such a hard day seeing them together when it should be us. We're supposed to be in Mexico. It was supposed to be his birthday surprise. You will get over it. You're in shock right now. 6 years is a significant amount of time and you just found out. Give yourself grace. Mourn the relationship. Time is the best healer. But you must detangle, no crying in front of him or your mutual friends. Don't speak to him except the logistics of one of you moving out. Then change your phone hash at the very least, block him, and the friends that knew. Block anyone mutual on social media, with so you'll never see anything pertaining to him. Take the money and go on a solo bacha and unplug. Get to know yourself again as no longer his fiancé. Consider therapy. Get a new haircut, buy new clothes. Take care of yourself, eating or drinking protein shakes, use the sleeping aid if necessary, work out and drink lots of water. Pastime staying busy. New and old hobbies, new fitness routines, rekindle friendships, do things and go places you've always wanted but he didn't. Pursue those professional opportunities you gave up for him. Live for you. Look forward to the future and new experiences you're going to have. Count your blessings you found out before marriage and kids and your student loans are paid. I'd kill for that. That chapter is closed and you have many ahead. You're going to be okay. Think of all the things in the past you thought you'd never make it through, yet here you are. You'll get through this too. Wishing you all the luck. I had a very similar situation. Boyfriend of 6 to 7 years, I wanted a future, he claimed he did but on the side was getting close to a co-worker. They fucked while I went out of town to respectfully give him some space because I could feel him pulling away from me. Our roommates and others knew before I did, and one of my friends didn't bother to tell me and actually sided with him and badmouthed me to his new bitch. It's now been a little over a year and I'm in a much better place with a much better guy. Why do you want to be with someone who chooses another girl over you? Who doesn't care about when you get hurt and who isn't excited to get married to you? There is someone better out there who will fulfill all of your wants and needs, but you need to work on yourself first. It's hard AF and it fucking sucks, but you can do it. Take it day by day, let yourself process. Delete social media apps if you must. I made a whole new profile on a few apps just to get away from old memories and mutual friends. I unfriended and blocked him on everything. I blocked those shitty friends too. I still have some anger towards people and still struggle to accept I may never get apologies from them, but ultimately, who cares? My life is so much better now without him and the rest of them dragging me down. You've got this. Start looking out for you and doing what's best for you, and the rest will follow. You need to do two things to move on from this. 1, you need to realize that he wasn't who you thought he was, that the image that you have of him in your head was exactly that, an image in your head, and not an accurate representation of who he really was. Similarly, you need to accept that the relationship you had with him wasn't the relationship you thought you had, it was a mirage, a false image intentionally planted by him. 2, you need to permit yourself to mourn who you thought he was and the relationship you thought you had, even though neither was real. I'm positive that they felt real to you at the time, which is really no surprise and not something you should blame yourself for. He must have spent a lot of time and effort acting the part, so don't beat yourself up for falling for his theatrics. I'm really sorry this was done to you, it was a very low blow from a pair of really low and cowardly people who, in time, you'll come to realize you're better off not having in your life. Consider, also, the situation from their perspective. Both of them will always know how they ended up together and what kind of betrayal and dishonesty the other is capable of. It will always be there, ready to poison their relationship at the first hint of any trouble, and what relationship is ever just smooth sailing all the way? So the seeds of their destruction was planted right from the very start for them, a terrible start to a relationship with a much better than average chance of ending in tears. Meanwhile, you are still able to keep your head high, and while you should probably take some time to heal before entering into a new relationship, know that your next relationship will, right off the bat, have much better prospects than theirs. Now for the next story. Wasted years 30 plus. Repost bots took first one. June 21st, 2021. Okay, this started when my wife died 3 years ago. We married in 1986. Waiting for a postmortem that took 2 weeks. Needed the paperwork so we could put her to rest. The sons and I decided to start recycle her things she left behind. Charging up old phones, laptops to see if they still worked, and going through her papers, we found a cache of love letters she had kept hidden from me. Long story short, she had been having an affair that started in the first year of the marriage, about 6 months in, until he died 7 years ago. Cancer. So his last text says I check him out and he did die of cancer. I didn't know a thing about it as I worked nights. Backstory: we met at a holiday camp in Scotland in 1979. We dated till we married in 1986. She came from a small village. We married and live in this village until her death. Finding the hidden love letters from HiApp, I find out he thought that one of the kids we had was his. We have 4 boys. I also found out I was the laughing stock with the whole village that all knew. I've lived in this village for 30 plus years and I'm still the outsider. Blind as a bat, I worked permanent nights 4 days a week. I didn't see any red flags. Even now looking back, I still don't. Seems she could gaslight for Scotland in the Olympics. He was a friend of the family from talking to her kids. They knew nothing. They say he was never around late at night. If he came to the house, he always left by 2100 hours or 9 p.m. I left for work around 2130 or 9:30 p.m. if you don't do 24 hours clock. From the letters and texts, it was well known in the village and that I'm the laughing stock. The boys 2-1 in DNA test and 2 don't. 2 think it might be them. The other 2 say I'm their dad. Revenge. I owned the plot next to where her mom and dad are buried. She wanted to be next to the mom and dad, one side her app on the other. Found that out from the texts on her phone and the graveyard registry. So when the body and paperwork was released, I had her body moved 300 miles away down to England and buried in a grave down there. I didn't have time to cremate her first. The village is pissed at me as I moved out back to England. Nowhere near her grave, a place I don't go. I told them they made me the outsider for 30 plus years I live in the village and they never forgive me for being born in England. That all knew what she was doing and never told me. I feel sorry for the kids, really. Imagine finding out your dad isn't really your father after your mom dies, and then find out your father has been dead for a few years. Going from happy family to orphan essentially, but with this dude who raised you as his own feeling like a chump. I hope you continue to love all 4 of your boys. There is nowhere for them to go, they've grown and they'll have families of their own soon. This is probably the only situation I can think of where I would say to not get those tests done, mate. Now for the next story. My girlfriend of 12 months cheated and hidden a huge secret from me. I'll share the full story because even though it officially ended 3 weeks ago, I'm getting flashbacks and having trouble processing it all, plus I'm not sleeping well at night. 12 months ago I met a woman online who presented herself as a semi-successful businesswoman who had owned a massage shop and was planning another. I'm all for women doing well in the workplace, and when she said this, I was super impressed with what she'd accomplished by herself. Soon after our first date, we arranged a second and third and fourth. She told me she had children on the second date, and due to her nationality, Thai, I decided to Google how to make a good impression with a Thai family. It's said to bake something fresh and bring it over for everyone to enjoy. Now, I'm not a chef. I can't bake to save my life. But I practiced over and over until I made the perfect brownies. I took them over and was introduced to her mother and children. It went perfect. By this stage, I was starting to think we could work long term. Everything seemed too good to be true. And it was. One day we had all been out and taken photographs of the day. I told her I'd see her in 2 weeks because I'm working long days with work, etc. 2 weeks passes and I call her up the night before I'm due to see her. She ignores my call. Weird. We'd been in a relationship for 4 months now. She texted back saying she wasn't well and she'd see me tomorrow. So I went the following day. She was off with me. I picked up her phone to send over the photos we took 2 weeks earlier, and what I saw sickened me to my core. In her photo album was a picture of her in bed with another man. Date stamp on the photo was last night. I confront her and it gets worse. She tells me it was for money. The guy paid her for sex. My eyes were like waterfalls. Why didn't you ask me? I'd have bought you food if you're that low on cash. I felt sick and drove home. She begged and begged me to forgive her, and it took a lot of strength, and after a few weeks I give it another go. 6 months later it was forgotten about pretty much and things seemed okay. Not for long. Her Thai friend came over and introduced herself as working with my girlfriend. The friend called my girlfriend by a different name. My girlfriend immediately began crying as if to say oh shit. I googled the name and it turned out that my girlfriend was a very well-known prostitute in the area and regularly slept with men for cash. My heart was racing. I'd spent 8 to 9 months with this woman and loved her like crazy. But that's when she told me she wasn't doing it anymore. And sure enough, I had no evidence to say otherwise. Then she asked me if she can move in with the children. Of course, my mind was destroyed, so I said I'm not ready for that. Not yet. I needed to process everything. A few days later I Google her name yet again because I can't believe that the woman I fell in love with was a prostitute and had been hiding it from me. And a brand new fresh review of her was at the top of the screen. Just 1 to 2 days after she asked me to move in, she did sex with someone else for around $140. We broke up 3 weeks ago and I found out today she slept with someone else within 3 weeks of leaving me. Right now I'm a broken man. She told me she loved me so many times and broken me and took advantage of me. I hope I can recover in time. It has hurt me to my core. Now for the next story. Tinder ruined my life. This is gonna be a long one, but I need advice on how to recover, if it's even possible to. I'm 48 and have been in many relationships over the years, but when I met my now ex-boyfriend, 43, back in 2017, I was determined to prove to him that not all women were like his previous cheating slash users, that he had tried to do everything in his power to give them everything in order to make things work, and they still never did anything except take everything they could and dumped him. I honestly loved him so much that I overlooked all the obvious warning signs of a very extremely toxic relationship between us, but I kept believing that if I just kept giving my everything that things would get better. First warning sign: there was absolutely no affection from him whatsoever. He suffered from an extremely bad case of erectile dysfunction. The doctor told him that he could prescribe shots to help with the problem, but he always had an excuse for never going back to the doctor to get the prescription the entire 2.5 years, so there was absolutely no sex between us at all, except that he was able to get off by me giving him oral sex, and so anytime he wanted that I would be the best girlfriend possible and do what I felt was my obligation and willing preform. I always thought it was odd that every single time I did this he never made a sound, his eyes closed, and he never touched me at all, and the second he was done he would go to the farthest side of his of the bed and turn his back to me and was instantly asleep. Never once in the whole relationship did he ever touch me in any kind of sexual way other than me giving him oral. Yes, I got used crying myself to sleep a whole lot. This was something I got used to and accepted as the way things were always gonna be. I stayed and continued to give the relationship everything I had, and the longer it went on the more I did to give to him and made sure that I took care of any and all of his needs, wants and desires that I was humanly possible without complaining or hesitation, because I believed in my heart that in his own way that he loved and would learn to change eventually, and I didn't cheat. I just learned to never have any of my needs taken care of and accepted that is just the way things were always gonna be, but I loved him so I just kept praying that maybe someday things would change. He was just a country boy and I trusted him wholeheartedly and knew would have in million years expected just how much more horribly my entire life was about to get, because by this time I had already stopped taking care of even my own basic human needs for my own self to survive, because I was always too busy making sure to be there taking care of his. There was absolutely no time left for anything that I needed, but I scraped by. Then it happened. The night it happened, he was asleep and I couldn't, so I was awake about 3 in the morning and he was next to me asleep, and I can only say that he did this by accident, but he left his phone on the bed charging, face up instead of face down like normal, and it light up with a message from some other woman off the hookup site Tinder, and I was in shock and my heart shattered, and I got up and went out of the house to leave, and he came out asking where I was going. I asked him what he was doing on a hookup site Tinder and he got angry, and his exact words to me were, "I was looking for your replacement," and then I just asked him why he never would go get the shots so that we could be together sexually. His response broke my down worse than anything up till this point in my entire 48 years. He said that the thought of having to touch me disgusted him and repulsed him to the point where he wants to throw up at the very thought of it. I left, and over the next few weeks he refused to stop blowing up my phone begging for me to give him another chance, that he would never go back on Tinder and he'd do anything to make things work, and I finally agreed to take him back because I loved him. I really worry for your sense of self-worth. It sounds like you have a habit of forming codependent relationships where you put the other person ahead over yourself to the extreme. You may not be in this particular situation with this one guy anymore, but until you learn to love yourself and put yourself first, you are going to continue to define your worth based on some random guy. Please get some counseling to address the trauma, and do some research on attachment theory. I strongly recommend the book Attached, helped me learn to have much healthier relationships, and read up on recognizing codependent relationships / gaslighting. Life is too short to trap yourself in a self-destructive cycle where you prioritize other people's problems over your own. It's not selfish to care of yourself. Good luck. P.S. When someone shows you who they are, believe them. Stop wasting your time on someone who isn't showing the signs of love and respect you need to feel secure in the relationship. People change if they choose to, not because you want them to. Alright, here's the stone cold advice for you. I know you feel less than, but that's nonsense. You need to cut that out. Those are his words, not yours. You gave everything to a piece of shit. So consider the source and let that shit go. Easier said than done, I know, but he's a manipulative scumbag. His shitty words are not a reflection of you, they reflect the shitty, stanky, nasty void inside him, nothing more. If you let someone else value you, you will always feel like a victim. There are good men out there. He's not one of them. But you need to give your everything to you, and you alone. Only you can value yourself. No one else can do that for you unless you let them. Self-esteem comes from within, not from outside. No one will be able to give you, or take from you what you're not willing to allow. So some scumbag was manipulative to you. Are you going to let some limp dick loser tell you who you are and what you're worth? Hell no, you're not. Because you love yourself and respect yourself and let no one dull your shine. You've got this. I believe in you.